Hello, everybody. Thanks for coming to my talk, and thank you, the Pog and Be My Hub, for inviting me to speak here today. So we are going to talk about task and document API, so how to manage your activities and everything in the system. So first, my name is Mathieu Calba. I work at a company called Captain Train, and it's a solution for booking train tickets easily and quickly. You can check out the apps and website, and we are hiring, so if you want to come work on a handsome team, just check out on our website. I'm also a GDG organizer at Lyon, so if you want to come to Lyon and do a talk, don't hesitate to come and ask me. So, first, does everybody know what we mean by a task in Android? No? Not really? Okay. Well, in Android, an activity represents a screen, and an application is often composed of many activities, and when the user navigates in your app, he can go like this and can go deeper in different screens. And this flow of activities of screen that is displayed successfully for the user is it's a task. It's an ordered queue of activities. It's called the back stack, and it's a LIFO queue: first in, last in, first out. And there is at least one element in it. So. Tasks are presented in the overview screen, which is presented when you tap on the recent button, which is at the bottom right on the Nexus devices. And you see a list of tasks here. Since 1.0, it's only icon and name. Screenshot was added in 4.3. And icon and name customization was added in 5.0 with a big revamp of the screen. This is the evolution. So first, you had just icons and tech and labels. So it was really app-centric here. And we progressively moved to something more like fork task and job, done, job to be done focus. So technically, how does it work? So there is two main ways. There are attributes on the activity tag in your Android manifest, and there are some flags on the intent that you can use. Well, there is a lot of attributes. Some of them are useful, but not all for every use case. And basically, you're going to need one or two maximum in your application if you're doing something a little funny. But if you're doing a launcher, then you have a lot more things to think about, and these attributes are very important. There is also a lot of flag activities. The same thing, some are useful, but not all for the basic use case. So we can have fun with flags here. And really, that's the main purpose here, fun. So what is the standard behavior we want to have in our application? Well, we start the application from the launcher. So when we start the application, we can look at the intent produced, and there is an action, action main. There is a category. Launcher. This information just are the same as what you put in your manifest on the activity that you want to be displayed in the app drawer. So not, not surprising at all. And also there is some flags. First, there is a new task, and there is the reset task if needed. Reset task if needed, it's a flag to help you restart your activity and your task instead of recreating it from scratch in some cases. The most important one is the new task. It starts the activity in a new task, depending on the task affinity. That's what's in the documentation, and it's correct, mostly. If a task has already this activity, this task is restored, and the intent is delivered to the unnew intent method. The task affinity we talked about just before, so it's an attribute that you put on your activity tag in your manifest. It's used to determine which task this activity will be launched when started with flag activity new task. By default, it's the application's package name. So basically, that means that when you're starting the application from the launcher, it's not the same application. It's not the same affinity that we are in. We are in the affinity of the launcher. So obviously, the flag activity new task work to create a new task for your activity. But in your application, if you have one activity that starts a new activity with the flag activity new task, but you didn't put the task affinity flag, then it will be launched in the same task as you because the task affinity by default is the application packet name. So you need to put it there if you want to really put this activity in another task. When inside the application, we want to start an application, we do a simple start activity, and the intent received is no action, no category, no flags at all. That's normal. When we put the application in the background and we restart it from the overview menu, the same thing. Nothing special, the intent is empty. And the screen might be restarted from scratch because some memory management occurred. So, and the system delivers the same intent the activity was created at first. Then we can go back and the activity might be restarted because some memory management occurred, and the same intent is delivered in this case. It's the intent with the main action, the launcher category, and the other flags. So that's a basic usage, but there is really, really a lot more to do it. First, you can use another app to do a job. For instance, in your application, you might want to take a picture for putting a profile picture on the profile use of the user. You can use the app to do that instead of recreating and taking a picture yourself. So it's less work, so it's better. You can have many entry points in your application. For instance, you can handle different URLs inside your application. For instance, Captain Train, we handle the Captain Train slash search URL to open directly the application in the search tab of the application, and then the user, when he click on the link, instead of opening the browser, it opens the application, which is a better experience normally. So, and there is a last but important part, it's multitasking inside an application. Basically, before 5.0, you had to manage yourself the multitasking if you want to manage multiple documents, for instance, multiple Google documents, you have to manage yourself a way to switch between these documents inside your app. And with the improvements we've seen, you can now manage this at the system level, and it's way better and way easier for the user to switch between these different documents. So we're going to look at the first one. So we can open a URL. When we want to open a URL, we start an activity with the data with the URL. What behavior does occur? Is this open in a new task or not? Well, it depends on the opened application. For instance, with the old Android browser, it's a new task. With Firefox, it's a new task. With Chrome, it's the same task. So we don't know what is the correct behavior here to do, but we know there is a problem because different applications are doing different things. They are all browsers, so they should do the same thing. When we open the same task, what we can see in the intent, it's action view, just like we defined, and two flags, forward results and previous stop. They are not very useful here. It's just for forwarding the result of a future launch activity back to the originate activity. And there. And when opening a new task, we see the flag activity new task that is put there. So why did it appear here? So what we can see by looking at the older Android browser's manifest is that we have a launch mode, single task. So what is launch mode? It determines how an activity is launched by the other activities, and there is many value. The first one, the default one, is standard, and you create a new instance of the activity all the time. It can be anywhere in the stack, and which task it is launched is determined by the presence of the flag activity new task and the task affinity attribute. So that's a basic usage we've seen earlier. There is also the single top value. There again, we have new instance for an activity most of the time, can be anywhere in this task, and which task is determined by the presence of the flag activity new task and task affinity attribute. But there is one little difference. If the targeted task already has this activity at the top of it with this launch mode, we create a new instance. Instead of creating a new instance, we just bring back this instance and put it at the front of the user, and the intent is delivered is a new intent. That's similar to what I've talked about earlier when we are putting a specific flag to restart the activity. There is also a single task, which we've seen in the Android old manifest, and only one instance of the activity. That's the main difference. Always the root activity of the task. And other activities can be in this task, but only standard and single top activities. So basically, it means that there is only one first screen in your application, and this is this activity. And finally, there is single instance, only one instance of the activity, always the root activity of the task, but the difference is that it's alone in its task. So it's really, 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 really rare to have a case like this. Basically, every start activity behaves just like if the intent has the flag new activity. Indeed, it has the flag activity new task. Because basically, how does it work? There is one class in the, not in the framework, but in the Android source, it's activity stack supervisor, which is really long, and there is one method, start activity unchecked locked, which is like 600 lines, and it basically rewrites every flags depending on the different attributes you put there. So what that means is for just before, like if you have single instance, it forced to put flag activity new task. And in this method, we can see that every behavior that we determine in launch mode or other attributes can be overridden by the flag activity flags that we can put in the intent. Well, we are just limited by the number of flags that is possible and the different possibilities and combination. So the question is, what is the correct behavior? I think that when you're opening the browser, as the browser is just a utility for your app, it should be stay in your application's task, because the user is going to see content related to your app. So in most of the case, it's going to be OK to be in the same task. But what you really need to know is that the user in the menu overview will see the screenshot of the browser inside your application with the brand of your application, with the icon, the name, and the color. So it can be strange for the user to see that. But mainly, nothing can be done to prevent a new task from being launched there. Because when you have a launch mode that is put in your activity tag, you can't prevent it when he wants to create a new task. You can't force to create a new task, but you can prevent creating a new task. The next use case is taking a picture. So when you're taking a picture, you're doing a start activity for results. The important part here is that it only works when you start in the same task. When Android wants to get back the result to the previous activity, it needs to be in the same task. If it's different task, the user can switch between different tasks and he can kill any process. So the user, the launched activity can send back the result. So what does it mean is that when you're doing a start activity for a result and it's opening a new task, there is an activity that result canceled result code that is sent directly to your activity. We also have the sharing via mail. So it's a simple example. So we had an action and we had some data and we start the activity. It's launched in the same task, but it's not the expected behavior that we want in 5.0. Because, for instance, Google decided that we need to have the compose mail in a new task every time. That's what they've done with the email application and with the Gmail application. And unfortunately, when you're doing that, this is the intent that you received. So nothing indicates that you can create a new task. Here you just have the habituated flags. So how can we change this? Maybe we can use flag activity new task, but we don't want to be launched in the target application task. So we need to do another thing because we can't indicate in which task we want to create our new screen. So we are outside the other application. So the new way to do this is the flag activity new document. It starts a new task dedicated to this job. There is a new mail, an original application. The other applications are still accessible. You can navigate between his mail and the original application easily with the overview screen. And he can restart the original task from the overview. So it's the user is not lost. But it's only 5.0, so how can we do compatibility? Well, the good thing is that the flag activity new document is just the same value as the flag activity clear when task reset. And it was explained by Jan Akborn when it was launched, this functionality, because the behavior is really, 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 really close. So it starts the job in the same task. So you are in the same task. So when you're starting to share, it opens in your application's task. But when you put the application in the background and go back with the recent menu, for instance, this activity is deleted directly, and you go back to your activity, not the sharing via mail activity. So the way you can do this is just by adding a check on the version code and add the correct flags. They have the same value, but it's better to avoid the deprecation warning. So easy. This way you can do it better. And the second part, it's to have multiple entry parts in your application. You have a different kind of entry point. You can have multiple entry points internally. For instance, you can have a notification, a widget, a rare application, and this will launch some activities in your application, but it can be another activity that's the main activity. It can be a detailed activity. And externally, you can have multiple icons in the launcher. The use case is very uncommon, but you can do it. And you can respond to public intent. For instance, you can respond to create an email, taking a picture, and other things. So internally, for instance, at Caption Train, we have a notification that displays during the trip the information for the user so he can know where he need to go to take his train. And when clicking on the notification or the display Aztec code button, it launched directly the detailed tickets activity with the Aztec code opened. How can we do this? So we use pending intent because it's a notification, and pending intent is basically an intent to be launched in the future. So we just create a task stack builder to create a stack of activities. Instead of creating one activity directly, that's the detail of the that's a detail screen, and when the user go back, he go back nowhere, so on the launcher. Here we want the user to go back to the home screen of the application. So we create a stack with the detail activity as an end activity, and it will recreate the hierarchy on its own. And when we see the intent here that is delivered to our activity, we can see that there is a flag activity new task and brought to front, which help us brought the task to front and the activity to the front of the queue if needed. So we can create a stack of activities, and there is the task stack builder. It's on Jelly Bean Plus and also on the Compat library. What can we do with this? We can add a parent stack. So basically, it will read the parent activity name in the Android manifest, and it will know what is the parent activity. You can add multiple intents. So you can call multiple type, add next intent to create yourself multiple activities directly. If you want to customize it rather than use the parent activity and the things that are defined in the manifest. You can also do both in the same line, just like you did before. And you can start the activities, and it will start the stack of activities. You can also create a pending intent directly, just like we did just before. So here we have the correct behavior. We are happy. Everything is OK. Now, externally, we can have so multiple icons in the app drawer. The use cases are very uncommon. So for instance, you can have a business application that is on a custom tablet that needs to do multiple jobs. So you have one APK, for instance, because it needs to share some code particularly, and you didn't want to use other things. So you can put multiple icons in the manifest. For this, it's quite easy. You just need to add the intent filter to the activities you want to be present in the app drawer. It becomes interesting when you're using non-standard Android launch mode. That means that if you use this but use the standard launch mode, it will always add the activity to your task because you have only one task. But if you're using a different launch mode, you can have your application with multiple instances. For instance, you can have Google did this at first with Google Maps. There was one icon for Google Maps, one icon for navigation, one icon for addresses, and one icon for location. Basically, the last two are useless, but the navigation, the user could start directly a navigation action, or he could start a map and then see, okay, I'm in a map, and then I can start the navigation. It was okay, but most of the users didn't launch directly the navigation application, so they removed it and they focused only on the directly launching Google Maps application. You can also intercept URLs. For instance, to do this, you need to add an intent filter with the action view, the category default and browsable, and then you need to define the schemes, the hosts, and the different paths you want to catch. So what happens when we are launched by some application because we are intercepting some intent? From the old Android browser, we have this, this intent. So view, browsable, OK, and the flag forward result, previously stop. So no new task, that means we are in the same task. So that means the user is see our application inside the browser information. So there is a browser icon, the browser name, but the screenshot of your application in it. That's quite disturbing for the user. Fortunately, it's the old Android browser, not the new one. With Firefox, for instance, when you click on a link, it always opens Firefox. You can't intercept URLs from Firefox. That's really strange for me, but I don't know why they did like this. You can open a link from the email application. This is the intent that we receive, the view, the browsable, and of course the URL. But here we have another information. We have the new task, clear when task reset, and new document. What we see here is that there is a little duplication in the flag because having new task and new document, when we are in 5.0 plus, it's useless. New document is just what we need. But at least we are in a new task, so it's good. With Chrome, it's better. You have only new task, so it's okay. We are in a new task. Everything is perfect. The question is, what is good behavior? The good behavior, like I told earlier, it's the new task. Because you want the user to be able to switch between the browser and your app. What can we do to force? What we see in here is that the application that opens, that starts the link is responsible for how our application is opened. If it is in a new task or it is in the same task. So you have two solutions to force the new task. It's either you let the current behavior and let some user have some bad experience, or you can use another solution is to force the creation of a new task on your side at the expense of some clean code, because it's a little strange to do this, and because you're changing the way Android works. Android works with normally you have some links for one activity, some other links for another activity. The solution is to use a single task, launch mode, and a special activity that will catch all URLs that you need to catch in your application. That way, this activity will always be started when you're catching an URL. It's always be started in a new task. But then, what you do is you always redirect directly in the onCreate to the correct applications. Basically, you create a router of URLs inside your application, and you need to manage this correctly. And when you've started the other activity, you finish yourself, and you be careful by setting the term no display to not at all being displayed for the user. He won't see you in the recent menu, the overview menu, or in visually when he starts the activity. Now, just a little. I don't necessarily recommend this solution, but it's if you really need to be careful about this, I didn't find any other solution. Maybe there is, but I didn't find one. So now, the third part: multitasking inside an Android application. Why do we want? We want to have multiple documents opened at the same time. We want to write an email and can look at other email for references. We want to multitask at the system level. For instance, Chrome can switch between different tabs directly in the overview menu. But it really depends on the application. For instance, a chat application, it's not really the use case to have multiple documents for every people that you talk with. So it really depends on the application. You need to be careful of when you're using this API. So the document API, which is 5.0 plus, like we've seen earlier, it's a move from app-centric to document-centric system. It's really different. The concepts are really different because the user is not focused on using an application. He's focused on doing one thing. And doing one thing is doing a job, doing another job. You can use the same application to do multiple jobs, or you can use one, instead of using a different app every time. and it's an extension of the task API. So how do we create a new document? We have first the document launch mode, so yet another attribute. There is multiple values for this as well. There is into existing. So you have only one instance of this document, one task. And it's the same thing as when you put flag activity new document on the intent. So it's the standard launch mode is required here because there is a conflict of interest between launch mode and document launch mode. And launch mode prevails on document launch mode. So you can have only one instance of this document. It's useful for some cases, but I didn't find any one now. There is the next one, which is always. You can have multiple instances of this document and multiple tasks. So it's the same thing as putting flag activity new document and flag activity multiple task on the intent. So you can recreate it on your side if the targeted application didn't have this behavior. And the launch mode still needs to be standard. And this is what Chrome does, for instance, or Google Drive, to have multiple documents at the same time. You can have the launch mode node, so it's a default value. New task only if flag activity new task or specific launch mode or flag activity new document. So it's OK. And you can have never. And even with flag activity new document, there is no new document task. It's always started in new activity. I don't know any use case right now that can be useful for this, but it's nice to have it. So we can also limit the history. So for instance, Chrome, you can open a lot of tabs. But here, we are limited between 1 and 50 for one activity document. So default is 16. And for instance, Chrome, if you want to open like 100 tabs, if you want to do this, you need to have two activities with the max recent to 50. So we can also start activity in the background. For instance, here we are in the Chrome application. We can open a new tab. It's the same website, so Chrome decides to open it in the same task. And as you can see, they are grouped together. They are just one below another and not separated with a lot of space. And how to do this is really simple. You just have to create an activity options with activity options dot make task launch behind, and you need to pass a bundle corresponding to this activity option when you're starting your activity. It forces a grouping of the documents with the original activity, and it forces the behavior of document launch modes to be always. You can also manage your different documents. It's important because you don't want to clutter the user experience with too many things open and don't manage it correctly, don't close it correctly. You can get the list of your documents with getAppTask. It returns an activityManager.appTask class, a list of this. And it can contain a lot of information on the task and what you can do with it. You can, for instance, finish and remove. We've seen, we'll see just after that what does it do. You can move a task to the front. So you can, for instance, choose to directly put at the front a document. If the user is opening the same document, you can know this and directly move to front the document, or instead of relying or reopening the same document in a new task. You can also get a lot of task information with recent task info. You have the base activity, the base intent, the number of activity. You have the task description that we'll see later on what we can do with it. And it's quite clear how the API works. And when you're in a document API, you might want to terminate the screen and keep the document, or you might want to terminate the screen and terminate the document and close it. And when you're doing finish, it will only terminate the activity, but the task will remain in your overview screen. So what you need to do is call finish and remove task on the app task we've seen earlier, and this will remove the task in the overview menu. So it's nice, it's a really nice API, but how can we do compatibility, just like we've seen earlier? You use the flag activity new document when launching an external activity on 5.0 plus, and on pre 5.0, you need to use flag activity clear task when reset to get roughly the same behavior. You can also customize the overview screen, so you can get the task description as we've seen earlier with recent task info, and you can set a task description directly in your application also. So you can put it in your activity. You create a new task description with a label, with a bitmap, so you can put another icon, and you can put another color for your primary color. And I've done it for the Captain Train application, so you can see the default one with a green bar and Captain Train, and the other one is the one that I customized. As you can see, there is a difference in color of the label, white versus black. It's because the system calculates what is the best color to display on your color primary. Well, for us on Captain Train, we have black on green. It's not cool, but we can't do anything about it. The algorithm is open, but we can't modify it. The solution is to modify the green, but we can't modify the green, so we are stuck with the black on green. There is also persistent behaviors. That means before 5.0, when you power down your device and restarted it, all the tasks were killed. Now we can decide to restore it in a different mode. So the default value is of this attribute, its persistable mode, is to persist root only. That means that we only persist the start activity of each task. And that means that when you're rebooting your device, you're going to see all of the activities in your overview menu that was present in the previous start of your device. So it can be difficult for the user to understand why everything is there. There is a lot of information, and then the user will just swipe to delete your task. It will delete every task. So it's not cool. You can have the value persist never. So if the activity is the root of the task is not persisted. Because the root activity defines how the task behaves and how the task is restored or not. But you can also choose to persist across reboot your task and the way you're there. So the activity is persisted across reboot with this value for the attribute. And in the onCreate and onSave instance methods, you can restore or persist some data across reboots with a persistable bundle. It can be useful, but not every time. So for instance, you might want to save the change of on a document for a user. That can be useful because it doesn't want to lose data. So it can be a good way to do this. So what we learn is you want to choose the behavior you want wisely. The system one is not always the best one. And you want to use a new task only where there's a break in your application's flow. And the API is very complicated but powerful, and it was okay, and it was improved with the document API. The document API is a really, really, really great improvement, really simple to use. So I encourage you to use it in your application. Thanks a lot. Do you have any questions?
Hi. When I use the task manager builder, the task stack builder, does it create each activity or it just drop in a list and when I go back in my back stack, it creates the activity at this moment?
It just creates the activity when needed. So it will just create the last activity, then it will recreate the previous one when the user go back with the back button or the up button if you use navigation tools. Yes.
When you call start activities with a plural.
Yes, yes. The start activities is what is used by a task stack builder to create a list of activities. And then I didn't check it, but I think it will only start the, it will start the intent just the last one, then when you're going back, it creates the precedent. But I'm not sure about this, I need to check. Well, thank you, have a good lunch.